The plan is Mulberry Lost episodes and Mega Man 3. It's going to be live.
A beginning is a very delicate time. Know then that it is the year 10,191.
Begin by simply listening. Slow down. See just how peaceful today can be. The plan for this one is going to be Mulberry, the lost episode.
In this time, the most precious substance in the universe is the spice melange.
And
the spice extends life.
Thanks for swinging by. Wish us luck.
Spice expands consciousness. The spice is vital to space travel. The Spacing Guild and its navigators, who the spice has mutated over 4,000 years, use the orange spice gas, which gives them the ability to fold space. That is, travel to any part of the universe without moving. Oh yes, I forgot to tell you. The spice exists on only one planet in the entire universe. A desolate, dry planet with vast deserts. Hidden away within the rocks of these deserts are a people known as the Fremen, who have long held a prophecy that a man would come, a messiah, who would lead them to true freedom. The planet is Arrakis, also known as Dune.
Begin by simply listening. Slow down. See just how peaceful today can be. I am your host, your obedient servant, Sebastian St. Smalls. The plan for this one is a Mulberry Lost episode and Mega Man 3. Thanks so much for swinging by. Wish us luck. Let's see. This one's the right way. That one's fine.
Music cue, a cheerful and upbeat tune plays in the background. Miss Farnaby narrates. Miss Farnaby, hello, dear listeners. My name is Miss Farnaby, and I'm going to tell you a story. A story about love, life, and death. A story about a young man named Mulberry, who came into my life and changed it forever. A story about how he made me happy, and how he broke my heart. But let's start from the beginning, shall we? It was a sunny day in spring, and I was having a picnic with Mulberry in the garden of my mansion. He had prepared a basket full of delicious food and drinks, and he had also brought a surprise for me. A painting that he had made for me. SFX, birds chirping, wind blowing, grass rustling. Mulberry, here we are, Miss Farnaby. The perfect spot for our picnic. Miss Farnaby, thank you, Mulberry. You're very kind. Mulberry, it's my pleasure, Miss Farnaby. You deserve the best. Miss Farnaby, oh, stop it. You're making me blush. Mulberry, well, you do look lovely today, Miss Farnaby. That dress suits you very well. Miss Farnaby, thank you, Mulberry. You're very sweet. Mulberry, and you're very smart, Miss Farnaby. You know so much about everything. Miss Farnaby, well, I do like to read a lot, Mulberry. Books are my best friends. Mulberry, and you're very funny, Miss Farnaby. You always make me laugh. Miss Farnaby, well, I do like to joke a lot, Mulberry. Laughter is the best medicine. Mulberry, and you're very brave, Miss Farnaby. You always face your challenges with courage. Miss Farnaby, well, I do like to live a lot, Mulberry. Life is too short to be afraid. Mulberry, and you're very special, Miss Farnaby. You're unlike anyone I've ever met. Miss Farnaby, oh, Mulberry. You're too kind. Mulberry, no, Miss Farnaby. You're too kind. They laugh. Miss Farnaby, oh, Mulberry. You're such a joy to be with. Mulberry, and so are you, Miss Farnaby. They smile. Mulberry, Miss Farnaby. Miss Farnaby, yes, Mulberry. Mulberry, I have something for you. Miss Farnaby, you do. Mulberry, yes. A surprise. Miss Farnaby, a surprise. What is it? Mulberry, close your eyes and hold out your hands. Miss Farnaby, all right. SFX, she closes her eyes and holds out her hands. Mulberry, okay. Now open them. SFX, she opens her eyes and gasps. Miss Farnaby, oh. It's a painting. Mulberry, yes. A painting of you. Miss Farnaby, of me. Mulberry, yes. Of you as a young woman. Miss Farnaby, oh. It's beautiful. Mulberry, do you like it? Miss Farnaby, like it. I love it. It's amazing. Mulberry, really. Miss Farnaby, really. It's so realistic. It looks just like me when I was young. Mulberry, well, I tried to capture your essence, Miss Farnaby. Your beauty, your grace, your spirit. Miss Farnaby, oh, Mulberry. You're so talented. Mulberry, thank you, Miss Farnaby. You're so generous. Miss Farnaby, thank you, Mulberry. You're so thoughtful. They hug. Miss Farnaby, this is the best gift anyone has ever given me, Mulberry. Mulberry, this is the least I can do for you, Miss Farnaby. They look into each other's eyes. Miss Farnaby narrates, that was the moment when I realized that I had fallen in love with Mulberry. And that he had fallen in love with me too. Music cue, the cheerful and upbeat tune fades out. Miss Farnaby narrates. Miss Farnaby, that night, I went to bed with a smile on my face, holding Mulberry's painting close to my heart. I felt happy and hopeful, thinking that maybe, just maybe, I had found true love at last. But little did I know that my happiness was about to be shattered by a terrible revelation. A revelation that would change everything. SFX, clock ticking, door opening, footsteps. Mulberry's father, there she is. Sleeping like a baby. SFX, he approaches the bed, and reaches out his hand towards Miss Farnaby's chest. Mulberry's father, goodbye, Miss Farnaby. It's time for you to go. SFX, knock on the door. Mulberry, Miss Farnaby. Are you awake? Mulberry's father, damn it. It's him. SFX, he withdraws his hand and hides behind the curtains. Mulberry, Miss Farnaby. It's me, Mulberry. Can I come in? Miss Farnaby, sleepily, Mulberry. Is that you? Mulberry, yes, it's me. Can I come in? Miss Farnaby, of course, dear. Come in. SFX, he opens the door and enters the room. Mulberry, hello, Miss Farnaby. I'm sorry to disturb you, but I wanted to check on you. How are you feeling? Miss Farnaby, I'm feeling fine, thank you. Why do you ask? Mulberry, well, I was worried about you. You looked a bit tired today. Miss Farnaby, oh, don't worry about me, Mulberry. I'm just old. Mulberry, no, you're not old, Miss Farnaby. You're young at heart. Miss Farnaby, oh, Mulberry. You're so sweet. Mulberry, and you're so kind. They smile. Mulberry, Miss Farnaby. Miss Farnaby, yes, Mulberry. Mulberry, can I sit with you for a while? Miss Farnaby, of course, dear. Come here. SFX, he sits on the edge of the bed. Mulberry, thank you, Miss Farnaby. Miss Farnaby, thank you, Mulberry. They hold hands. Mulberry's father, whispering, what is he doing here? He should be gone by now. Miss Farnaby, narrates, what we didn't know was that there was someone else in the room with us. Someone who was watching us with anger and disgust. Someone who had come to take me away from this world. And from Mulberry. SFX, clock ticking. Music cue, the cheerful and upbeat tune changes to a dark and ominous tune. Miss Farnaby narrates. Miss Farnaby, as we were holding hands and smiling at each other, we heard a voice behind us. A cold and harsh voice that made us shiver. Mulberry's father, well, well, well. What do we have here? SFX, they turn around and see Mulberry's father standing in the doorway, wearing a black hat and dark clothes. Mulberry, father. Miss Farnaby, father. Mulberry's father, hello, son. And hello, Miss Farnaby. Miss Farnaby, who are you? Mulberry's father, I'm his father. Miss Farnaby, his father. Mulberry's father, yes. His father. Miss Farnaby, but. Mulberry's father, but what? Miss Farnaby, but he never mentioned you. Mulberry's father, he never mentioned me. How rude of him. Mulberry, father, please. Mulberry's father, please what? Please don't embarrass you in front of your girlfriend. Miss Farnaby, girlfriend. Mulberry's father, yes, girlfriend. Don't tell me you're not his girlfriend. You're holding hands, you're smiling, you're saying sweet nothings to each other. What else are you? Miss Farnaby, narrates, I felt a blush rising on my cheeks. I looked at Mulberry, who looked equally embarrassed. We didn't know what to say. Mulberry's father, well. Are you his girlfriend or not? Miss Farnaby, well, I. Mulberry, well, we. Mulberry's father, well, well, well. You sound like a pair of sheep. He laughs. Mulberry's father, oh, this is too funny. This is too rich. My son, the Grim Reaper's apprentice, has fallen in love with a human being. A human being who is old enough to be his grandmother. He laughs louder. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I felt a pang of anger and hurt. I looked at Mulberry, who looked shocked and scared. We didn't know what he meant. Miss Farnaby, what did you say? The Grim Reaper's apprentice. Mulberry's father, yes, that's right. The Grim Reaper's apprentice. That's what he is. That's what he was supposed to be. Miss Farnaby, supposed to be. Mulberry's father, yes, supposed to be. Until he met you, and decided to play house with you. Miss Farnaby, play house. Mulberry's father, yes, play house. Pretend to be your friend, your servant, your lover. Pretend to care about you, to make you happy, to give you gifts. He points at the painting. Mulberry's father, like that pathetic painting over there. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I felt a surge of pride and love. I looked at Mulberry, who looked proud and loving too. We knew what he meant. Miss Farnaby, that painting is not pathetic. That painting is beautiful. Mulberry's father, beautiful. Ha. It's a lie. A lie that he painted for you. A lie that he told you. Miss Farnaby, a lie. What lie? Mulberry's father, the lie that he came here to help you. To serve you. To love you. He laughs. Mulberry's father, he didn't come here for any of those reasons. He came here for one reason only. To take you to the next world. He stops laughing. Mulberry's father, that's right. To take you to the next world. To kill you. SFX, Miss Farnaby gasps. Music cue, the dark and ominous tune continues. Miss Farnaby narrates. Miss Farnaby, I couldn't believe what I was hearing. Mulberry's father had just told me that Mulberry was a Grim Reaper's apprentice, and that he had come to kill me. To take me to the next world. I felt a wave of fear and disbelief wash over me. I looked at Mulberry, who looked terrified and guilty. I didn't know what to think. Miss Farnaby, is this true, Mulberry? Is this true? Mulberry, Miss Farnaby, I. Miss Farnaby, is this true? Mulberry, yes, Miss Farnaby. It's true. Miss Farnaby. Miss Farnaby, it's true. Mulberry, yes, Miss Farnaby. It's true. Miss Farnaby narrates, I felt a stab of pain and betrayal in my heart. I looked at Mulberry, who looked ashamed and sorry. I didn't know what to feel. Miss Farnaby, why, Mulberry? Why? Mulberry, Miss Farnaby, please. Miss Farnaby, why did you do this to me, Mulberry? Why did you lie to me? Mulberry, Miss Farnaby, I didn't lie to you. I just didn't tell you everything. Miss Farnaby, you didn't tell me everything. You didn't tell me anything. Mulberry, Miss Farnaby, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Miss Farnaby, sorry. Sorry for what? For pretending to be my friend. For pretending to be my servant. For pretending to be my lover. Mulberry, Miss Farnaby, I wasn't pretending. I was being sincere. I was being honest. Miss Farnaby, honest. How can you be honest when you hide such a big secret from me? How can you be honest when you have such a dark purpose? Mulberry, Miss Farnaby, please listen to me. Please let me explain. Miss Farnaby narrates, I felt a mix of anger and curiosity in my mind. I looked at Mulberry, who looked desperate and hopeful. I didn't know what to say. Miss Farnaby, explain. Explain what? How can you explain this? Mulberry, Miss Farnaby, please. Please give me a chance. Miss Farnaby narrates, I felt a trace of love and compassion in my soul. I looked at Mulberry, who looked scared and sad. I didn't know what to do. Miss Farnaby, all right, Mulberry. All right. I'll give you a chance. But make it quick. And make it good. Mulberry, thank you, Miss Farnaby. Thank you. He takes a deep breath. Mulberry, Miss Farnaby, it's true that I'm a Grim Reaper's apprentice. It's true that I came here to take you to the next world. It's true that it was my duty. He pauses. Mulberry, but it's also true that I changed my mind when I met you. It's also true that I decided to stay with you instead of taking you away. It's also true that it was my choice. He pauses. Mulberry, and it's also true that I love you, Miss Farnaby. It's also true that I love you more than anything in this world or the next. It's also true that it was my heart. He pauses. Mulberry, that's all I have to say, Miss Farnaby. That's all the truth there is. He looks at her with pleading eyes. Music cue, the dark and ominous tune continues. Miss Farnaby narrates. Miss Farnaby, I listened to Mulberry's words, and I felt a whirlwind of emotions. I felt confusion and doubt, wondering if he was telling the truth or not. I felt fear and sadness, thinking that he might leave me or take me away. I felt anger and resentment, feeling that he had betrayed me and lied to me. But I also felt love and gratitude, knowing that he had made me happy and cared for me. I looked at Mulberry, who looked sincere and earnest. He looked at me with pleading eyes, waiting for my answer. I didn't know what to say. Miss Farnaby, Mulberry. Mulberry, yes, Miss Farnaby. Miss Farnaby, Mulberry, I. Mulberry's father, enough of this nonsense. Enough of this drama. SFX, he steps forward and interrupts them. Mulberry's father, this is not a soap opera. This is not a romance novel. This is reality. And reality is harsh and cruel. Miss Farnaby, who are you to say that? Mulberry's father, I'm his father. And I'm your reaper. Miss Farnaby, my reaper. Mulberry's father, yes, your reaper. The one who has come to take you to the next world. The one who has the power to end your life. Miss Farnaby, end my life. Mulberry's father, yes, end your life. That's what I do. That's what he does. That's what we do. Miss Farnaby, why? Why do you do that? Mulberry's father, why? Because it's our job. Because it's our duty. Because it's our destiny. Miss Farnaby, destiny. Mulberry's father, yes, destiny. We are grim reapers, Miss Farnaby. We are the agents of death. We are the ones who collect the souls of the dead and bring them to the next world. Miss Farnaby, the next world. Mulberry's father, yes, the next world. The world beyond this one. The world where you belong. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I felt a chill in my spine. I looked at Mulberry's father, who looked cold and stern. He looked at me with no pity or mercy. Mulberry's father, you see, Miss Farnaby, you are not supposed to be here. You are not supposed to be alive. Miss Farnaby, what do you mean? Mulberry's father, I mean that you have lived too long, Miss Farnaby. Too long for your own good. Miss Farnaby, too long. Mulberry's father, yes, too long. You are old, Miss Farnaby. Very old. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I felt a sting in my pride. I looked at Mulberry's father, who looked smug and arrogant. He looked at me with contempt and disdain. Mulberry's father, you are old, Miss Farnaby. And you are lonely. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I felt a pang in my heart. I looked at Mulberry's father, who looked cruel and mocking. He looked at me with scorn and ridicule. Mulberry's father, you are old, Miss Farnaby. And you are miserable. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I felt a tear in my eye. I looked at Mulberry's father, who looked evil and hateful. He looked at me with hate and malice. Mulberry's father, you are old, Miss Farnaby. And you are worthless. SFX, he raises his hand towards her chest. Mulberry's father, and that's why you must die. Music cue, the dark and ominous tune reaches a climax. Miss Farnaby narrates. Miss Farnaby, I saw Mulberry's father raise his hand towards my chest, and I felt a surge of panic and despair. I thought that this was the end. That I was going to die. But then, something unexpected happened. Something miraculous. SFX, a bright light flashes, and a loud sound echoes. Mulberry's mother, stop. SFX, Mulberry's father's hand is blocked by another hand. Mulberry's mother, stop right there. SFX, Mulberry's father and Miss Farnaby gasp. Mulberry's father, what? Who are you? Mulberry's mother, I'm his mother. And I'm your wife. Mulberry's father, my wife. Mulberry's mother, yes, your wife. The one you left behind when you became a Grim Reaper. Mulberry's father, you. Mulberry's mother, yes, me. Mulberry's father, but. Mulberry's mother, but what? Mulberry's father, but how? How did you find me? How did you get here? Mulberry's mother, that's not important right now. What's important is that you stop what you're doing. Mulberry's father, stop what I'm doing. Why? Mulberry's mother, because it's wrong. Because it's cruel. Because it's unfair. Mulberry's father, unfair. To whom? Mulberry's mother, to her. To Miss Farnaby. Mulberry's father, to Miss Farnaby. Why should I care about her? Mulberry's mother, because she's a human being. Because she has feelings. Because she has a soul. Mulberry's father, a soul. A soul that belongs to the next world. Mulberry's mother, no, a soul that belongs to this world. A soul that deserves a second chance at life. Mulberry's father, a second chance. Why? Mulberry's mother, because she has learned to appreciate life and love through Mulberry. Because she has changed for the better. Because she has made him happy. Mulberry's father, happy. Him. He looks at Mulberry, who nods. Mulberry's father, you're happy with her. Mulberry, nods, yes, father. I'm happy with her. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I felt a warmth in my chest. I looked at Mulberry, who looked happy and brave. He looked at me with love and devotion. Miss Farnaby, whispers, thank you, Mulberry. Mulberry, whispers, thank you, Miss Farnaby. They smile. Mulberry's mother, to Mulberry's father, you see, my dear. You see how much they love each other. You see how much they need each other. Mulberry's father, to Mulberry's mother, I see, my dear. I see how much they love each other. But I don't see how much they need each other. Mulberry's mother, to Mulberry's father, they need each other more than you can imagine. They need each other more than we ever did. She sighs. Mulberry's mother, to Mulberry's father, don't you remember, my dear? Don't you remember how we used to love each other? How we used to need each other? She pauses. Mulberry's mother, to Mulberry's father, before you became a grim reaper. Before you left me alone. She cries. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I felt a sympathy in my heart. I looked at Mulberry's mother, who looked sad and lonely. She looked at Mulberry's father with longing and regret. Miss Farnaby, to Mulberry's mother, I'm sorry, dear. I'm sorry for your loss. Mulberry's mother, to Miss Farnaby, thank you, dear. Thank you for your kindness. She smiles. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I felt a bond in my soul. I looked at Mulberry's mother, who looked kind and gentle. She looked at me with gratitude and respect. Miss Farnaby, to Mulberry's mother, you're welcome, dear. You're welcome. They hug. Mulberry's father, to Mulberry's mother, what are you doing, my dear? What are you doing? Mulberry's mother, to Mulberry's father, I'm doing what's right, my dear. I'm doing what's right. She lets go of Miss Farnaby and faces Mulberry's father. Mulberry's mother, to Mulberry's father, I'm here to tell you that you can't take her. You can't take Miss Farnaby. Mulberry's father, to Mulberry's mother, I can't take her. Why not? Mulberry's mother, to Mulberry's father, because I've spoken to the higher authorities. Because they've agreed to give her another chance at life. Mulberry's father, to Mulberry's mother, the higher authorities. Who are they? Mulberry's mother, to Mulberry's father, they are the ones who make the rules. They are the ones who decide who lives and who dies. Mulberry's father, to Mulberry's mother, and they've decided that she lives. Mulberry's mother, to Mulberry's father, yes, they've decided that she lives. But on one condition. Mulberry's father, to Mulberry's mother, what condition? Mulberry's mother, to Mulberry's father, that he leaves her. That but he never sees her again. She points at Mulberry. Miss Farnaby narrates, "I felt a shock in my body. I looked at Mulberry's mother, who looked serious and firm. She looked at Mulberry with pity and sorrow. Miss Farnaby, what? Mulberry, what? Mulberry's father, what?" The episode ends with a close-up of Mulberry's face, as he looks at his mother with disbelief and confusion. Music cue, a sad and melancholic tune plays in the background. Miss Farnaby narrates. "Miss Farnaby, hello again, dear listeners. This is Miss Farnaby, and this is the second and final episode of my story. A story about love, life, and death. A story about a young man named Mulberry, who came into my life and changed it forever. A story about how he made me happy, and how he broke my heart. But before we continue, let me recap what happened in the previous episode, in case you missed it or forgot it. Or in case you're just too lazy to listen to it again. Don't worry, I won't judge you. Much." SFX, she clears her throat. "Miss Farnaby, it all started when I had a picnic with Mulberry in the garden of my mansion. He had prepared a basket full of delicious food and drinks, and he had also brought a surprise for me. A painting that he had made for me. A painting of me as a young woman, with a smile on my face. It was a beautiful painting, and I loved it. I loved him. And he loved me too. But then, everything went wrong. That night, his father came to my bedroom, and tried to take my soul. He tried to kill me. He was a grim reaper, you see. And so was Mulberry. Yes, you heard me right. Mulberry was a grim reaper's apprentice, and he had come to take me to the next world. To kill me. But he didn't do it. He changed his mind when he met me. He decided to stay with me instead of taking me away. He decided to love me instead of killing me. He told me the truth, and he asked for my forgiveness. He said that he loved me more than anything in this world or the next. And I forgave him. And I loved him too. But then, something unexpected happened. Something miraculous. His mother appeared out of nowhere, and stopped his father from taking me away. She said that she had spoken to the higher authorities, and that they had agreed to give me another chance at life. But on one condition. That Mulberry must leave me. And never see me again. That was the end of episode 1. And this is the beginning of episode 2. SFX, the sad and melancholic tune fades out. Miss Farnaby narrates. "Miss Farnaby, Mulberry's mother gave him some time to think about his choice, to stay with me in this world, or to return with her to the next world. I didn't know what he would choose. I didn't know what I wanted him to choose. I wanted him to be happy, but I also wanted him to be with me. I wanted him to stay, but I also wanted him to go. I wanted him to live, but I also wanted him to die. I was torn between love and selfishness, between hope and fear, between life and death. And so was he." SFX, clock ticking. Okay, I will use my best judgment about first-person narration versus actual dialogue, but I will also try to include more lines for the radio script. Thank you for your feedback. I will continue with the next scene of episode 2. Dash. Music cue, a sad and melancholic tune plays in the background. Miss Farnaby narrates. "Miss Farnaby, as we were waiting for Mulberry to make his choice, we tried to talk to each other. We tried to say what we felt, what we thought, what we wanted. But it was hard. It was hard to find the right words, the right tone, the right moment. It was hard to say goodbye." SFX, clock ticking. Miss Farnaby, Mulberry. Mulberry, yes, Miss Farnaby. Miss Farnaby, I'm sorry. Mulberry, for what? Miss Farnaby, for everything. For being angry and hurtful. For being old and lonely. For being miserable and worthless. Mulberry, don't say that, Miss Farnaby. Don't say that. Miss Farnaby, but it's true, Mulberry. It's true. Mulberry, no, it's not true, Miss Farnaby. It's not true. Miss Farnaby, yes, it is true, Mulberry. It is true. Mulberry, no, it's not true, Miss Farnaby. It's not true. He holds her hand. Mulberry, you're not angry and hurtful, Miss Farnaby. You're kind and understanding. Miss Farnaby, thank you, Mulberry. Mulberry, you're not old and lonely, Miss Farnaby. You're young and loved. Miss Farnaby, thank you, Mulberry. Mulberry, you're not miserable and worthless, Miss Farnaby. You're happy and precious. Miss Farnaby, thank you, Mulberry. They hug. Miss Farnaby narrates, he thanked me with his words, and I thanked him with my tears. He thanked me for being kind and understanding, for being young and loved, for being happy and precious. And I thanked him for being sweet and sincere, for being brave and honest, for being loyal and noble. We thanked each other for being ourselves. For being together. But we knew that it wouldn't last. We knew that we had to part. And we didn't know how to do it. SFX, clock. Music cue, the sad and melancholic tune plays in the background. Miss Farnaby narrates. Miss Farnaby, as the clock was ticking, we knew that we had to make a decision. We knew that we had to say goodbye. But we didn't want to. We didn't want to let go. We wanted to stay. We wanted to hold on. We wanted to live. We wanted to love. But we couldn't. We couldn't have it all. We had to choose. We had to sacrifice. We had to die. We had to kill. And it was up to him. It was up to Mulberry. SFX, clock ticking. Miss Farnaby, Mulberry. Mulberry, yes, Miss Farnaby. Miss Farnaby, have you made your choice? Mulberry, I. Miss Farnaby, it's okay, Mulberry. It's okay. Mulberry, no, it's not okay, Miss Farnaby. It's not okay. Miss Farnaby, why not, Mulberry? Why not? Mulberry, because it's not fair, Miss Farnaby. It's not fair. Miss Farnaby, what's not fair, Mulberry? What's not fair? Mulberry, this. This whole situation. This whole condition. Miss Farnaby, what condition, Mulberry? What condition? Mulberry, the condition that I have to leave you. The condition that I have to never see you again. Miss Farnaby, I know, Mulberry. I know. Mulberry, do you, Miss Farnaby? Do you? Miss Farnaby, yes, I do, Mulberry. Yes, I do. Mulberry, how can you, Miss Farnaby? How can you? Miss Farnaby, because I love you, Mulberry. Because I love you. She kisses him. Miss Farnaby narrates, I kissed him with all my heart, and he kissed me back with all his soul. We kissed as if it was our first kiss, and our last kiss. We kissed as if it was our only kiss. We kissed as if it was our goodbye kiss. SFX, clock ticking. Music cue, the sad and melancholic tune plays in the background. Miss Farnaby narrates. Miss Farnaby, after we kissed, we looked into each other's eyes. We looked for a sign, a clue, a hint. We looked for an answer. But we didn't find one. We didn't find anything. We only found silence. And sadness. And then, he spoke. He spoke the words that I had been dreading to hear. He spoke the words that broke my heart. SFX, clock ticking. Mulberry, Miss Farnaby. Miss Farnaby, yes, Mulberry. Mulberry, I've made my choice. Miss Farnaby, you have. Mulberry, yes, I have. Miss Farnaby, what is it, Mulberry? What is it? Mulberry, I've decided to. He pauses. Mulberry, I've decided to go with her. He points at his mother. Miss Farnaby narrates, I felt a shock in my body. I looked at Mulberry, who looked calm and determined. He looked at his mother with love and respect. Miss Farnaby, you've decided to go with her. Mulberry, yes, Miss Farnaby. I've decided to go with her. Miss Farnaby, to the next world. Mulberry, yes, Miss Farnaby. To the next world. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I felt a pain in my heart. I looked at Mulberry, who looked sad and sorry. He looked at me with pity and sorrow. Miss Farnaby, why, Mulberry? Why? Mulberry, because she's my mother, Miss Farnaby. Because she's my mother. Miss Farnaby, and what about me, Mulberry? What about me? Mulberry, you're my love, Miss Farnaby. You're my love. Miss Farnaby, then how can you leave me, Mulberry? How can you leave me? Mulberry, because I love you too much, Miss Farnaby. Because I love you too much. He hugs her. Mulberry, narrates, I hugged her with all my strength, and she hugged me back with all her weakness. We hugged as if it was our first hug, and our last hug. We hugged as if it was our only hug. We hugged as if it was our goodbye hug. SFX, clock ticking. Music cue, the sad and melancholic tune plays in the background. Miss Farnaby narrates. Miss Farnaby, after we hugged, we let go of each other. We looked into each other's eyes one last time. We looked for a memory, a smile, a tear. We looked for a goodbye. But we didn't find one. We didn't find anything. We only found silence. And emptiness. And then, he left. He left with her. SFX, a bright light flashes, and a loud sound echoes. Mulberry's mother, come on, son. It's time to go. Mulberry, yes, mother. It's time to go. SFX, they disappear. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I saw them disappear in a flash of light, and I felt a void in my soul. I looked at the empty space where they had been, and I felt nothing. Nothing but loneliness. And grief. And then, I cried. I cried for him. I cried for me. I cried for us. SFX, she cries. Miss Farnaby, narrates, I cried until I had no tears left. I cried until I had no strength left. I cried until I had no life left. And then, I slept. I slept for a long time. I slept for an eternity. SFX, she falls asleep. Music cue, the sad and melancholic tune fades out. Miss Farnaby narrates. Asleep. Music cue, the sad and melancholic tune fades out. Miss Farnaby narrates. Miss Farnaby, that was the end of episode 2. And this is the end of my story. A story about love, life, and death. A story about a young man named Mulberry, who came into my life and changed it forever. A story about how he made me happy, and how he broke my heart. A story that I will never forget. And neither will you. She pauses. Miss Farnaby, thank you for listening, dear listeners. Thank you for being with me. Thank you for being my friends. Goodbye. The episode ends with a close-up of Miss Farnaby's face, as she smiles peacefully in her sleep.
In a world where chaos reigns, and connections seem fleeting, one visionary endeavor seeks to bring us all together, when theater live after dark. Harnessing the transformative power of artificial intelligence, the timeless charm of radio theater. The wisdom of books, and the excitement of video games. When theater live after dark illuminates the path to enlightenment and fosters a sense of unity among its audience. Through this unique fusion of storytelling and interactive experiences, We aim to nurture personal growth, improve learning, and inspire a peaceful existence. Guided by your obedient servant, Sebastian St. Serapian Smalls, we embark on a journey of self-discovery. But where do we begin? Begin by simply listening, slow down, see just how peaceful today can be. Together, we shall create a harmonious community, bound by shared passions and a desire to elevate the human experience. Sebastian St. Serapian Smalls will be there, to the end of the line, my Valentine, guiding you on this journey towards a more serene and enlightened mind. Catch you guys on the flip side.
Begin by simply listening. Slow down. See just how peaceful today can be. Thanks so much for swinging by. Hope you had a good time. I know I did. Interesting episode. Catch you guys on the flip side. Okay, bye.